diesel needs fuel, but what are the two other functions of diesel in an engine? In this video, we'll find out. Thanks for joining. Most vessels have a diesel engine installed these days, a reliable iron jenny, and they require fuel to power them. Diesel has about 16% more power per litre of fuel than gasoline or petrol, 36,000 kilojoules compared to 31,000. The first and main function of diesel is to power our engine. Literally, to push down the piston to rotate the crankshaft. The second and still vital function is to lubricate the moving parts of the injection pump and the injectors. The gaps between metal parts in the injector can be as little as 2 microns. A red blood cell is 8 microns. The third function of diesel is to act as a coolant, removing heat from the injectors, which gets superheated by the burning in the combustion chamber. Diesel can be described as a reluctant burner. Obviously, it does burn, but not rapidly or with enthusiasm, as one might say. Gasoline, on the other hand, is very enthusiastic. Even the fumes are explosive and can sink a vessel. That's why vessels with gasoline or petrol engines are required to have blowers to exhaust potentially explosive gases from the bilge. This is relevant because the speed and ability of diesel to burn is important. We want the fuel to burn as quickly as possible after the injector has fired, to minimise the delay as much as possible. The speed and ability of diesel to ignite and burn is called its cetane rating. The higher the rating, the quicker the fuel ignites. In North America, the minimum standard is 40. In Asia Pacific, it's 45. And in Europe, it's 51. Unlike gasoline that can't be stored for a long time because the volatile gases evaporate, diesel can be stored. The cetane rating does fall over time slowly, but diesel can be stored for months, even years. The main danger is getting water into the fuel tank, causing contamination. There are two types of water in diesel. The first is called dissolved water, and this passes through the engine harmlessly, provided the amount is not great. Less than 200 parts per million. The real menace is what's called free water. Water at the bottom of the tank. If water reaches the injection pump and the injectors, they can be damaged in two ways. First, the water in contact with hot metal parts turns to steam, potentially with explosive force doing damage. Second, the presence of water is the absence of lubrication. The water dispels the oil which is lubricating, and this allows metal-to-metal contact and abrasion. So it's essential that the first filter in the fuel system has a water separating element and that any water is drained from the filter regularly. Another danger with the presence of free water, water at the bottom of the fuel tank, is that it encourages the growth of HUM, hydrocarbon utilizing organisms, slime-like organisms, yeasts, bacteria and fungi that will block filter elements and hoses and stop the engine. There used to be a lot of sulfur in diesel fuel. The danger is that sulphur and water, both free water and dissolved water, in the engine can turn to sulfuric acid, and this acid corrodes the iron parts inside the engine. So special oil was formulated to neutralise the acid. Look for C on the label. S is for gasoline or petrol engine, spark ignition. Now most diesel sold is ultra-low sulphur diesel. The standards for it vary around the world, with the cleanest being sold in Europe and the dirtiest still available in Central Asia. Diesel fuel contains wax, which precipitates out as temperatures fall. The wax clogs fuel filters and the engine stops. To prevent this, two types of diesel are sold worldwide depending on the regional climate. Colder climates such as Northern Europe and Northern North America get number one diesel from fall to spring. Warm climates, or in summertime, get number two diesel, what we think of as a regular diesel. So to recap briefly, diesel performs three functions in an engine. Fuel to burn to power the engine, lubrication for the injection pump and the injectors, and acting as a coolant to remove heat from the injectors and the injection pump, putting the heat into the fuel tank, which is one reason why the return line should go to the tank and not back shortcut to the secondary fuel filter. Cetane is a rating of the diesel's ability to burn. There are two types of water in diesel fuel: dissolved water, that is water in the fuel, and free water, water flowing with the fuel, usually lying at the bottom of a tank or the bottom of a fuel filter. Free water can encourage the growth of hum slime, which will block a fuel filter and stop the engine. Sulphur and dissolved water naturally containing diesel produces sulfuric acid, which is corrosive. This is counteracted by using the right engine oil for a diesel engine and by using ultra-low sulfur diesel. The cloud point of diesel is the temperature at which wax is precipitated from the fuel. Number one diesel is provided in wintertime, and number two diesel used in warmer climates and summertime. Well, thanks for watching. Please don't forget to like, share and comment on the video, and head over to my Patreon page. For as little as $3 a month, you can help me put subtitles on these videos. Until next time, I wish you fair winds and a reliable diesel.